Sometimes we need to load assets on demand from our scripts. An example of this will be to load a style sheet so we can give our UI elements a style. Another example could be loading assets without referencing them in Inspector for fast prototyping. To do so, Unity provides a load method from the resources class. This method receives a path and will try to load the asset that we want. However, it will only try to load assets that are part of a special folder called resources. The resources folder is not tied to the root folder, so we can create it anywhere we want, as well as how many times we want. If we have multiple resources folders, Unity will try to search for the asset in every single one of them. This also means that if you have multiple assets with the same name, Unity will only load the first asset it finds. Do note that in the build, everything inside the resources folders and their dependencies will be within a resources.assets file. This means that we won't be able to add something to that file once the game is built, and our assets will always be there even if we don't use them a lot. Because of that and some other details, our asset file names need to be unique through all of the resources folders. Also note that assets from a resources folder that's inside the editor folder will be removed from builds and will only be loadable from editor scripts. To showcase this method, let's create an editor window and load stylesheets. To do so, right-click in the project window, go to Create, UI Toolkit and Editor Window. Feel free to uncheck the UXML file as we are not going to use it. I'll call it Custom Editor Window. Unity places the scripts inside the editor folder right away, and will create it if you don't have one yet. We will now create two resources folders, one outside of the editor folder in the assets folder, and the other one inside of the editor folder. Move the editor window stylesheet to the editor resources folder. Note that resources inside of the editor folder are removed from the build. So, if your resources are supposed to be used in your game, leave the file outside of the editor folder. If you want to know more about the editor folder, feel free to watch my video about it. Go back to the other resources folder and create a new stylesheet by right-clicking in the project window, going Create, UI Toolkit and Stylesheet. I'll name it the same as the other USS file for testing purposes. Open both USS files in your code editor. In one of them, add the border color green style to a button. In the other one, add the background color red style to a button as well. Now, go to our editor window script, create the button and attach it to the root visual element. If we go to Unity, we can now see a button in the editor window. Now we need to load stylesheets so that we can attach it to our button. Because our stylesheets are inside the resources folder, we can use the Unity provided resources class and call its load method. Type in resources.load. There are two things we should specify in this method. The first one is the path of where the asset is located relative to a resources folder. This means that we do not need to send any path before the resources folder even if it is in the editor folder. In our case, it is right after the resources folder. So, we will type in custom editor window. Note that it shall not contain the extension file, and it is also case insensitive. We can now cast our returned file to something we'd want. In our case, it will be a stylesheet. However, this method will load any asset file on that path, even if it is from a different type, and will become null or give an error if the one found first cannot be cast. With our current cast, it will throw an exception if the returned file is not a stylesheet. If we want it to simply return null, we will need to use the as stylesheet at the end. To make sure we only search for stylesheets, we can add a second parameter specifying the type that we want to search for. To do so, we simply type in type of stylesheet. Now Unity filters the files for the type as well, meaning our current cast will also work without throwing exceptions. This works, but we can simplify this by using the generic type this method accepts. Simply remove the second parameter and the cast as well. And then pass the type after the load by typing stylesheet in between angle brackets. Unity will now filter the files for this type and will cast it right away. Now we add a stylesheet to the button stylesheets variable. Because the loaded stylesheet can come as null in case it doesn't exist, we should check for that before adding it to the button. If we save and head back to Unity, we can see that the background is red, but there is no green border. If we swap the styles in the folders, then it will be the opposite. The reason why is that both have the same name, which Unity then only finds one of them and adds that one to the button. If we wanted Unity to get both, we will need to use the LoadAll method instead. However, this is best used when we want to do something such as LoadAll files from this path or LoadAll textures from this path. So we shall still have different asset names. So simply give it two different names and load both stylesheets using the resources.load method. Loading assets with the resources load method is fine, but it's better used for runtime scripts. In our case, we are using an editor script. And Unity actually provides a load method for editor scripts, called load, but from the EditorGUIUtility class. The difference is that this method does not retrieve assets from the resources folder, and instead retrieves assets from the editor default resources folder. If it cannot find any there, it will try to find in Unity's built-in editor resources. So let's go ahead and create that folder. Note that this folder, contrary to the resources folder, needs to be in the root folder, meaning there can only be one. Let's move our editor resources stylesheet to this new folder. Let's also update resources folder stylesheet to a new name, so that we can test the method with both files. I'll just add 2 at the end of its name. Moving back to our editor window, swap the resources.load method with the EditorGUIUtility.load method. This load does not accept a generic type, and instead we need to cast it. We also need to type the extension of the file, which in this case is USS. Save and go back to Unity. Sometimes the editor window doesn't open. If that's your case, resetting the layout seems to fix that problem. You see that it is now loading the stylesheet. If we instead try to load the custom editor window to stylesheet, it won't load. If we didn't have the if check statement for null here, it will throw an error as the value will be null, as it could not find the file. And that's basically it for the resources folder. It allows us to load an asset from our folders by providing a path. However, it doesn't mean you should be using it for everything. In fact, a Unity Learn tutorial recommends you to not use it unless it fits in the proper uses of the resources system. Even then, I don't think Unity is quite sure of what to make of this folder. The Learn tutorial also recommends addressable assets and says the tutorial is currently deprecated. I'll probably only be using the resources folder for editor-related assets like stylesheets, as they won't go with the build, and for prototyping at runtime. I'm not quite sure how addressables work as I haven't learned about them yet, but I think it is important for you to know that they exist, just in case you are about to use the resources folder. You might also want to search about the asset database and such classes, to see which fits best for you or which Unity or the community recommends. I'll be leaving some links in the description if you are interested in learning more about these video topics, so feel free to check them. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you've enjoyed it and see you in the next one.